Boxing star Eric De Leon is still an amateur. He's 20 years old. He's a 10-time national champion and a person that Emmanuel Stewart has told me numerous times to look out for him, that this kid will be a world champion in no time. I caught up with Eric to talk to him about the passing of Emmanuel Stewart, one of the closest people to him in the world of boxing. On the phone with us all the way from Detroit, Eric De Leon, one of the most talented young fighters in the world, not only in the nation. Eric, how are you this evening?
I'm doing all right, thank you.
It was a very rough day for you yesterday. Can you tell me about it when you heard that Emmanuel Stewart passed away?
Yeah, it was. I couldn't believe it. You know, I felt really bad about it. And then they confirmed it in the afternoon, and I was just, you know, really upset. Me and my whole family, too. So it was a really tough day. Even till now, I can't even believe it. That, you know, a great man in boxing and just in general who helped me out a lot passed away.
Can you tell me about the history that you guys have for people? Because people didn't know or don't know about how close you guys were.
Yeah, I met him about 10 years ago at amateur boxing fights. And
you were 10 years old?
I was 10 years old. I remember it was at the Palace. It was a pro-am show, and they put me first to fight against a kid from Chicago, and I beat him in the second round. I stopped him in the second round, and then I went back to the locker room, and when I was on my way back, he seen me because I guess they had TVs in the locker rooms before the pro fights, and then he told me, you know, great job. If you need anything, I'm here to help you. You know, you fought really good. You know, I'm really proud of you. And then at the end of the night, I remember him telling me and another pro fighter were the best fights of the card, and I was just an amateur, so that felt great.
And not only that, but a few months back, I met you and I met Emmanuel right here in Southern California. You guys travel. What was it like to be on the road with Emmanuel Stewart as a fighter?
It was amazing. You know, I got really comfortable with him since I first met him. He treated everybody equal. He treated everybody the same. He was friendly with everybody. You know, he was such a nice person, and I learned a lot from him. We would talk boxing all the time. He would keep it real with me all the time. And he would just teach me, you know, about life and about boxing. He came real close, not just with me, but all the comp fighters and my whole family. And every time, you know, we would travel, he would tell me stories about boxing and Chavez and Oscar De La Hoya and all these great Thomas Hearns and all these great fighters he has. So that always motivated me, you know, to just talk about them and hopefully one day, you know, try to do the things that they did in boxing.
Eric, what were some of the stories or some of your favorite moments with Emmanuel Stewart?
Well, one of the things that I remember a lot was when me and him were at his house, and then he was gonna drop me off at my house. So he told me he had two bags in his living room, and he told me to pick them up, and he told me to get the two bags and take them to the car. So I grabbed them and I asked him what they were. And he told me they were, you know, the bags had food for somebody that lived close by my house that he was going to give them to help them out because they didn't, you know, they needed food. They didn't have much to live. They didn't have a lot of food. So that really hit my heart. He always wanted to help out and look out for people, anybody, not just at the gym or anywhere he could help somebody out. He would always, you know, help them out with anything he could. So that was really amazing for me.
One thing you have to say about him, even though he had 41 world champions, he was a celebrity, he was on TV on HBO, he never went Hollywood. How do you explain that?
Yeah, I couldn't even believe it. I mean, to tell you the truth, it just felt just like he was just like another father, just like another great person, you know, a great friend. He became so close to me, and he always showed me a lot of things about boxing, and I would learn with him about the sport all the time. Every time we travel or I'd be at the gym, he would try training me or helping me out and asking me, you know, is everything all right? Do you need help? Or how's training going? And he would just motivate me all the time.
He thought very, very highly of you. I remember him telling me that you will be a champion in no time, and if you wanted, you could go to the Olympics, but he didn't think that was the route to go because the Olympics is not what it used to be. What kind of boxing advice did he give you?
He gave me a lot of good boxing. He technique and a lot of boxing skills. He helped me out develop, you know, more defense, throw straighter punches, sit down on my punches more. Box, he always told me, you know, I had beautiful boxing skills, so just to use it, not to fight too much, just use my boxing and use my, you know, use my speed and move around, not to think a lot, and just use my skills more in box, be more technical in there. So from that, you know, I always try to do that and try to become better and win all the nationals that I win.
And having him in your corner, what was that like when you have a tough round, you sit down and you hear the voice of Emmanuel Stewart, and you're one of those fighters that loves boxing. You watch HBO, you watch Showtime, you even watch ES News, and you watch almost every video. So for you to sit down must be surreal sometimes to, like, wow, Emmanuel Stewart's talking to me.
Yeah, he had a busy schedule all the time. The person that was always mostly in my corner was his nephew, you know, from when I turned 17 to the summer, to last year in the summer and the Olympic trials. But he did got to work my corner a couple of times, you know, and he would inspire me. He would always tell me the right things, and I would do it, and it would always work out. I remember one time he took us to Carson, California, to fight in 2006 at the Blue and Gold, and everybody was all motivated, and everybody from Kronk, but like one fighter won the whole tournament. We got like first place in the tournament, and he worked my corner, and I won. I almost stopped the fighter, and I got like best fighter of the tournament, and I just felt great. You know, he worked my corner, and it was just crazy. I was sitting down, and he was telling me, you know, box or use your jab more, you know, just I'll box him, and it was like I couldn't even believe it. He was working my corner, telling me all these things, because I would always see him on TV.
And not only that, but for the city of Detroit, as you know, because you live there, it's a very rough place. It can be. It's hurting economically, the school system. What did Emmanuel Stewart mean to Detroit for younger generation, for the kids like you who are up and coming?
I think he was like the king of Detroit boxing. He would always try to help people out. Any kid that would go in the gym, he wouldn't even have to know him. He wouldn't even see him, and they went up to him and said hi, and he would say hi to him. He would give him a Kronk t-shirt, and that just motivated them, and that motivated the whole team. We would get great sparring, great fighters, great champions would go in there, and we would just see them train, and we would train with them, and that all made us work harder. And, you know, every time we would spar, we wouldn't even act like we were teammates. We would go in there and try to knock each other out.
Just recently, I'll tell people, you were sparring Nonito Donaire as he was getting ready for Nishioka. What was that like for you as a 20-year-old to spar a fighter that many people consider one of the best pound-for-pound in the world?
It was an amazing, you know, experience for me. I was so happy to be there, you know. It was great to spar with one of the best pound-for-pounds in the world, and then just to have fun in there and be around great people and spar with him was one of the best. It was great. I mean, for me, it felt so good. You know, I appreciate them sending me over there sparring with him, because, you know, that was a great experience for me. That only makes me better.
So the last thing, Eric, if you could share with us one more special moment of Emmanuel Stewart, whether in the gym or at his house, something that you could recall when you think about him right now?
Oh, yeah. There's many that we had together, but one of them was when he went to my house and we sat down and we talked, me, him, and my parents. You know, I could just see how happy he was and how happy my parents were just to spend time at the house and have, like, dinner together. That was a great moment for me. You know, I will never forget all the great times we had, but that was just an amazing time we had. We all had dinner, and he was just there like a regular person, like a regular friend, just having dinner with us. And my mom and everybody was just so happy to see him. My mom couldn't even believe it, because she would always see him on TV.
There you have it. Eric De Leon remembering one of the closest people to him, a person who was beside him for 10 years in boxing. Emmanuel Stewart, he will be missed. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ali Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And Eric, what's your Twitter?
GoldenDeLeon313.
So there you have it. Eric DeLeon for ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ali Sekpak reporting.